Right, I'm so committed to this cause. Here we go.
I know there's hair all over, but this is the setup I've got. My comb that's got wide tooth and fine tooth. I've got my razor, my Mizutani scissors, and then my thinning shears. And, of course, the clip.
My hair is clean and dried a little bit, so I'm just spritzing to make sure it's completely wet. So I'm going to basically section off. And this is for all of you girls who want to try to get, and boys, who want to try to get just freshen up layers you already have. My hair is like a lob that's been going out for about a year now. And so I basically want to freshen up these layers that are here so that my hair looks a little bit longer. So I'm going to basically go and I'm going to section a triangle section here. And it's not going to be too wide. So it'll be just a little, actually, let me do it with this. If you guys have like a rat tail comb, it's easy to use a rat tail comb. And then I'm going to tuck that behind my ear. Go on the other side. Oh, it's so fun doing this with hair in front of my face. And then just sectioning off this side now. And I actually am going to take a scrunchie. You guys have these. And just tie that hair back in a way so it doesn't get in my way. So, my finest look ever. And I'm going to comb that forward. And guys, for this first part, I really want to have tension. So, I'm combing that first section here. And out of that section, I'm actually going to make this easy for you guys. Just take the very center so you don't have too much hair. And I'm doing a middle part because I part my hair in the middle mostly. If you guys part your hair on the side or if you go back and forth, we can talk about that. So I'm just going to comb forward here and I'm using a fine tooth comb. And I'm basically going to just kind of eyeball how much I want to take off. I would use a razor normally, but I'll show you guys with scissors, how to do it with scissors. So I'm going to go in the very center and I'm just going to basically cut across, just straight across. And then I'm gonna kind of angle down as I cut down and then angle up to kind of meet what I just did there in the center. See if you guys can, I'll go shorter just so you guys can see. I'm eyeballing here. I'm gonna cut in the center across and then gonna kind of come down and I'm kind of etching at the hair. I'm not cutting like straight across, I'm just etching down. So that's my guide, that's my center section. Now I'm going to split in the middle, as close to the middle as I can get there. And now I'm going to comb the hair and I'm going to bring it at this angle, you guys. So you can see, I can cut now at an angle from short to long. Okay. And then the other side, same thing, just angle out this way. Fine tooth comb. And I can see now that where I want to connect that hair that I just cut, which is right underneath my knuckle and that long hair. And I'm just going to go and angle that and kind of connect it. And again, I'm not going straight across, I'm just kind of angling it so that they start to meet. And now I can comb forward all of that hair and make sure that my two ends, see them a little longer on that side. So now I can go through and just kind of make sure that those ends meet. And by the way, you guys don't have to get that particular, you're just getting yourself through the next, hopefully just a month. Now I'm gonna take my hair out. And I'm gonna comb forward again. Now I'm back in my middle part. I started on that first section, I parted it like right here. I'm gonna go back here now. So I'm gonna take from this here, and now I'm gonna triangle kind of just past my eyebrow. I'm sorry for your hairstylist watching, so don't even wash up your hairstylist because you don't care. Guys, here's the sitch. You want to make sure that first section, I didn't mention this, but that first section that we did, I'm kind of going to like this part, like the highest part of my eyebrow, like right around there. And now I'm coming out here. So just take little bits at a time, guys, because I'm worried if you go crazy, you're going to get hate mail. I would suggest doing this. And so I'm basically just taking that hair and I am going to just cut. Like I'm keeping it kind of angled out, cutting just like that. So now I'm still going from short to long, see? But I'm connecting that first section. And then on this side, I'll show you kind of what I would do with a razor because I need to get that same connection from our new section to the old. So you guys can see what I'm working with before I even go in there. I need to get rid of all that stuff there. So I'm gonna actually just hold it just like this with tension. I'm gonna see where that shorter piece is here and just start cutting down and slithering with my razor. If you really wanna like check it, bring your comb forward here. So see, there's a little bit of an area that I missed there. So I'm just gonna go in now and I'm cutting up, I'm not cutting across, just to take off some of that. Again, nobody's being graded on this. While I have this first little section out now, I'm gonna take my thinning shears. If you have fine hair, you want to make sure that you're doing blunt lines. If you have medium texture hair, you wanna take a little bit of weight out. If you have really thick hair, you're gonna wanna take a lot of weight out. So I'm using my thinning shears to take weight out of my medium texture hair. So I'm just gonna go through and kind of each section just kind of nibble on those ends a tiny bit. If you have really, really thick hair and you need to like take major weight out, take your scissors and basically what you would do is just go through and like take out some of the hair. I have faith in you guys, you can do this. So that's kind of like just the like front fringe area, and I cut quite a bit, like you guys can see. I've cut quite a bit.